The day of the race was rapidly approaching. Jack's training was intense and vigorous. 100 push-ups. 100 sit-ups. And a 10-mile run every day for 2 weeks. The race has officially arrived. This is his story.
That's what you wanted?
Ladies and gentlemen, I hope you buckled up your seats, because it's the main event of 2020, the moment you've all been waiting for. Here we are, finally, after 2 weeks of anticipation, introducing the Piranica!
Alright, racers, are you ready? In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go! I think both of these players use the same route too, so we shouldn't see anything too different as far as strategy goes.
This is fucking nuts, dude. Just
oh my
Dark
god. Now that the countdown has gotten me a little nervous, that's what I'm going to say. The problem is I am a bit nervous.
Some good movement and good angles from both players, I would say. This is looking promising.
Yeah, they got the setup for sure. Bob did grab it, and Jack, they both caught the bomb, and they're through the game. They've done it.
Okay, we got a ground pound from Jack into the tree. That won't save him time. But
it's
still
pretty
close to the match.
We're going to go because we messed up a little bit. We should have gone for...
Bob's going off the bridge now. He does miss the first cannon list. He's going for the backup star, and Jack hits it.
Let's go,
on his first try cannon list.
Let's go.
It looks as if he's aiming to get under that star, which takes a bit of precision, a bit of game knowledge. So will
he manage
to pull that off?
Let's go!
He will.
Let's go, baby! Let's go! Let's go!
Absolutely, absolutely. Let's hope he. I mean, this star's pretty standard one, but a death hero really. That was quite close.
He got it. That I thought he was gonna drop there for a second, but he did get it just in time.
That is not a time waste you would like to see. Well, Bob,
yeah,
will land on the platform safely. The camera angles make it difficult to tell. I think these are very, beginner camera angles. It's hard to see Mario's aligned on the platform.
Dude, I thought we died. I thought we fucking died, dude. I genuinely thought we fucking died.
Oh, he's juking out Bob.
Same thing's happening with Bob. He just needs to... Oh,
three grabs so far, four grabs, five grabs. Can he get the baby ping one? Right, I know.
I feel like my Bowser's
both of
a bit
their
better than
these are in the range of 20 to 21 minutes. So
holy shit, we almost just—it's
not a fully
completely
fleshed out
through the whole race.
Say, but yeah, I think the 8 red stars in Bowser 1 is probably one of the hardest stars you add to the run.
So God, dude, I'm fucking sweating.
Not too bad on this throw. It's a little underpowered. He now has Bowser on his backside, begging for mercy.
Begging for mercy.
Jack has just now entered SSL, and he's already sliding down the dune into the pyramid. Looks like a very clean, well-practiced.
Well, that was the one trick I was actually worried about, which would kill the
and
fucking.
And now rising. For his first star.
I'm still sweating,
so
bro.
Where... Oh, a death from Bob. That is not what you want to see.
Oh, he died. Let's go. Perfect.
Yeah, Jack has a really good run going here so far.
Perfect, dude. Oh my god. That's so much time save, baby. That he fucking died, dude. Oh my god. Let's go. Let's fucking go, dude.
You just have to keep pushing, and that's what both these players need to do.
That's right. And even though Jack is definitely making less mistakes, Bob's basement pathing, because he gets Talent Star, is a little faster. Jack is only one star ahead of Bob.
One star's but huge. About to pick one star's fucking massive, star. Dude.
Not as clean on the pyramid was Bob as Jack, but that's all right. There's we still have Mips. Mips can be a great decider of run winners. I think Mips can really.
Bob's Mips sucks. Bob's Mips sucks.
Same with these. Star,
sweet, we got perfect really rock RNG here. It's still perfect. That's what we like nothing to see, baby. True.
Bob finishes off his lava star, and Jack gets a clean no left boulder run on his first.
They are biased star. Commentators.
Make his way over the toad here. Say what's good. Because, jab, left, right.
Oh, okay.
Jack beats the shit out of Toad while Bob burns his ass.
I think Jack's run overall has been quite impressive. I can't remember.
Dude, they're starting to move to me. They're starting to be like, man, Jack, Jack's got a cleaner run. Jack's got the cleaner run, baby.
Oh, barely gets them. That was a clean Mips grab. He's got a good camera angle for it.
Does.
There it is. A very well executed Mip skip through the first door for Jack, as Bob is now cleaning up his boulder star.
Definitely. Oh, that's something else to consider. Bob is playing on Retro Arc for some fucking reason.
Bob, here's the biggest difference I think between their runs. Bob is going to be using the little hidden pathway. Yes. It looks like when Mario's playing in the main menu, just as you idle in the game, this is how he would get the star.
I'm surprised there's no press start flashing at the bottom left. That's it.
Quite quickly it makes it through the bottom floor of Bowser 2.
Now this is a pretty important throw to hit. I believe if you miss this throw and Bowser falls off the edge, it will waste the most time of any Bowser throw behind him before Bowser can even move, so... Fine.
Perfect.
That will
good
work.
Throw from Jack, and Bowser 2 is dead.
Executed pretty masterfully from Bob. I mean, that will. I think he actually has caught time on Jack.
That was a huge time save.
Yeah, he caught up. He caught up quick.
All right, Jack's lining it up. He is using Lactu Cam for his BLJs.
Won't quite get the first attempt.
Yeah, BLJs. Oh,
right
great
at the end. That was
top
clean.
Of that staircase. Wow. Can Jack keep the momentum going in the second staircase? There's a question. Oh, bonk from Bob. Walking up the staircase now. Using Mario Cam down for his first set of BLJs. A little bit different than Jack's strategy. Camera's a little bit off for Bob.
The BLJs finally catch for Jack. They weren't... Into the sky for Jack. He is... with great pace, I believe.
Bob trying to break through the brick wall still. Having some trouble on this. Mario now has a concussion, making his way down the staircase.
That is painfully unlucky from Bob. He won't be happy with that.
This is a
oh my god.
BLJs.
You definitely should aim for that door.
Oh my god, what if we PB? What if we PB?
While Jack heads into the Bowser throws. Now, these can really trip a lot of players.
One,
up,
two,
but,
three.
We'll just have to see. This could be the winning.
Let's
one,
see if he
two,
keeps that momentum
three.
Going. On throw
perfect.
Number two.
Oh!
We'll allow Bob some extra time to make up for his...
Bowser with the quick charge onto Jack.
One,
that's
two.
An unfortunate attack cycle.
Perfect.
But a good second throw. Really good lean. Velocity on that one. And he only needs one more to lock out game Jack. One.
One, two, three. Yes!
Is that it?
Yes! Let's go! Let's go, baby! Oh my god, let's go!
We're only 20 minutes and 50 seconds in. I'm not sure if this will be a PB or not.
Within 20 seconds of his PB, which is
yes!
A pretty good performance for your first race.
Hopefully really good first game performance, Jack.
Let's go!
I think a great match from both players. Bob, while he did...
Let's go! At least 20 so much time lost for the man! Oh! Baby!
All right,
let's go,
on,
baby!
Bob. Could you tell us if that was a PB?
No, that was not. I was 11 seconds off my PB. I think I still
okay,
beat
so
Bob's
close.
PB, actually.
Still a good run. Still a good run.
I can't believe... Right. I think I still matched with your PB, Bob, in that race. I think I hit a... think I had a 2050.
Yeah, you beat my PB.
Yeah. I'm sorry. Oh, that is not trying to sound mean.
Yeah, sure.
Okay. Alright, well, when I say go, both players should reset their games. 3, 2, 1, and go. Here we go.
I don't know how his loads in faster every time.
We'll see if Jack can do his first try cans again like he got on the first game. He does have a very quick canless setup.
Looking good so far. It's hard to tell from spectating, but he makes it. He makes the start.
First try canless again.
Bob can.
I think he missed it again.
Yeah, Bob can way too close. Second try canless. He does grab this ledge. Here's not too big of a time loss as long as he doesn't fall down entirely.
Now he has it.
If he gets this, he will still have the lead, but he's definitely bleeding time that he saved by getting the bomb clip. Ah.
Oh, this is alright. Bob just has to stay concentrated.
It's a big fall into the water as Jack picks up his fourth star, or third star, in Womps.
Dude, he's crouching under pressure
right now!
Bob is
starting his new Mario 64 Let's Play, taking
They called it a Let's Play! They called it a fucking Let's Play!
I've never seen this many coins on a Candleless Star.
me neither, but, you know...
Alright, surely, third... It looks like Bob had a little bit more momentum going through the cliff in that wall. But Jack has the advantage currently. He's now heading for MIPS in game two. Last game, he had a solid MIPS despite one misinput of ground pound. And again, catches MIPS at the same spot. Very good MIPS.
Boulders, but will ground pound in the middle between them to just to receive some good luck.
Jack got MIPS on his first attempt. Did take a little bit of time to line it up, but it's worth it to not go through the door without that bunny.
That is an interesting little trick.
Trying to dive and get the angle right into the star, dude.
We'll take his Let's Play strategies into game two with him.
Yeah, I don't know why he does that.
Staying on the stone blocks this time around.
Okay, this is where he can bring shit back.
Yeah, I've never actually seen this button be pressed before I saw Bob do the star. I didn't know it was there.
I didn't know either, brother.
We're on to the best, most interesting part of the run. BLJ's... That's if Bob can actually find Bowser's tap.
Oh, he died? So it's okay.
Death of Bowser too.
Okay, I've got time. I've got a little bit of time.
Die on that just yet.
Yeah, he's got to really hope that Jack has some trouble finding his BLJs here. We did see that Bob struggled in the first game to get up that first staircase. Looks like Jack's first attempt is not going to have enough speed to get to the star door. So he will soon be following closely behind Jack, who is still having trouble getting his first BLJs here.
Jack's still not
having a lot of trouble here.
Picking up enough speed. Bob, make his way back into the castle. He is willing to catch himself up. He will take
perfect.
That is a clean BLJs from Jack on the fourth attempt, I believe, though. He can potentially catch up. We see Bob hurrying to get these BLJs out.
Oh, he's got speed.
He's got some. I don't know if it's enough as Jack is trying to get the second one.
Staircase. Ooh, he's risky.
He's through. He has made it through the brick wall.
He perhaps approached that wall with the lowest amount of speed possible and still built up enough to get through. That is quite remarkable. Bob only seconds behind with a second BLJ.
No, this race is just one missed Bowser throw away from either player having game two.
Absolutely.
Jack resorting to some silly kicks to get up. He does make it up, though.
Interesting side flip!
That was a scary grab.
I'll take it. I'll fucking take it, dude. Whatever.
Both players are caught up to one another.
Bob's going to take the pull in the back, which is a little bit longer, but Jack is only just now making his way to the carousel here. This is
very close.
Extremely close.
Yeah, I think one missed throw from Jack will put Bob in the lead until he misses throw. That's the first one hit from Jack. This is a very close match.
They're both on the final Bowser throws. Jack only one throw ahead currently. Gets the second one.
Second throw. The third one is the hardest one to hit. So will he be able to...
Waiting for Bowser to come to a full stop to make it as easy as possible.
No! Shit!
Oh, that is going to be a missed throw from Jack as Bob lines up throw number two. That's a good throw from Bob. They both just need one more throw here.
One, two,
who's gonna
three.
Finish this off first? That's a good throw from Jack. He is burned though. Okay, he's not going off the edge with the fire.
Oh, that is very close.
Ah! Yeah.
Yes! Oh, yes! Man. Oh!
We beat him!
Do not hear! Staying the same, baby! The luck! The luck! Oh!
That's amazing. Now, I mean, I don't know. Do we do three matches even though it's best of three?
So, okay. If he wins this race, I still officially have won the competition though, right?
Well, here's the question. Do you want to up the ante to be a best of five instead of a best of three?
Well, I don't know what the ante would up to. I don't know what else I could do to him other than ruin his hair.
Bob, give up your stream key.
The stream key! Bob, I don't know if it's... I don't know if I'm down for it, man. I took the win.
What will Jack get extra if he manages to extend the tournament length and steal the lane on top? What will be the double or nothing situation?
I'm thinking about it. He doesn't need my money, obviously. He definitely does not need my money.
Okay. Dude, I don't want to run this for the third one, man. Oh, God. I'm down to run a race again for out of three, but the hair is already affiliated for him. The money is next. Is that bad? Is that bad? I'm down to run another two out of three. I don't know. Is that good? Is that too bad? The hair is in my hands already, but we run another two out of three, and either I can gift you subs, or I donate to a charity of your choosing if I lose.
All right.
You're in for it? All right, then let's, it's another two out of three, right?
Alrighty, we're resetting it. We're resetting it. New competition, new tournament.
All right, run it back.
Are you down for another three race?
three races, Jesus Christ.
Or two if I just cream you, man. Or two.
Right.
Yeah.
I don't even want to know what the pressure was like on that last
round. Dude, I was shaking.
I thought I won. I was like about to like go like be happy because I thought I won, but I looked over to my right screen and I see that Jack is like two like barely like 4 seconds ahead of me.
So I need to know, Bob, what are you gonna dye your hair? What colors?
I get to choose.
Right, what do you wanna pick?
Oh, I get to choose on stream?
Yeah, if you wanna pick now or you wanna tell
me. I think boys. I think I've come to between two choices.
Oh my god.
Two choices.
Oh my god.
So, please. I'm not gonna lie. My girlfriend told me what color you were gonna dye it, which was ninja blue.
No! What the hell? I hate so much.
Ninja blue has come to the final decision. And we agreed it was for a month, correct? You have to keep this for a month.
A month. I'm gonna talk during this one since this one doesn't really matter. I'm gonna talk through this one.
Okay, I'm gonna keep my mic muted.
Doesn't matter to you, Bob? Wow.
Ah, this one doesn't matter.
That's not what I said. No, I really appreciate that. Y'all took my words out of context.
All right, I'll count it down for the first game again. Y'all ready?
Right. Yep, I'm ready.
Runners, ready your emulator. Restart in 3, okay. 2, 1, go.
Oh fuck! It didn't start. Wait. Sorry, it didn't start.
Oh my god!
Great start.
No. All right, let's do it. I'm ready to go.
All right, hold on.
Are you Bob?
Are you strong?
Bob, if you mess
Bob, are you gonna fuck it up again? And then I'm going to go to the bathroom again if you fuck this up.
I'm making it too big of a.
Get ready, reset in 3, 2, 1, go.
And we're away again.
It is possible. I think it's more on Jack to mess it up than it is for Bob.
Yeah, that's so true.
That gets him ahead. Yeah, Jack really has just been playing too well. We'll see who gets lacked to here. Both players missed it.
Players. Ooh,
this is the first time I've seen Jack make a mistake on the start tonight. Missing one wall kick. And he gets up. Oh, but he doesn't miss that star platform. Oh, we have the chimney entrance from Jack. That is a classic occurrence. When you're going for that baby penguin, sometimes you just kind of slip into the chimney. It's interesting to see them do the same thing, albeit like 20 seconds apart. Oh, ground pound for good luck.
I wonder if Bob will ground pound in the same spot.
See, now that Bob is... the stakes are a little bit lower, you see him doing some better strategies. I wonder if he brought that out in the first couple of runs, if that may have changed something. Especially game two being as close as it was.
Well, Bob takes a lead. I mean, Bob is now in the pipe for Jack, which, I mean, he entered later, so...
And now, Bob actually has a slight lead over Jack for the first time tonight, I think.
No, I think we actually might lose this one, chat. Not gonna lie.
I can already tell that Bob is playing a lot better. I think the pressure from the first bracket definitely was making him make a lot of little mistakes. So it's possible that Bob will just take this lead and run with it.
Whatever works. Ooh,
oh, left boulder. Squashed a little bit there.
Nearly another one, but that's okay.
Oh, there it is. He said, give me your lunch money.
Give me your lunch money.
So Jack is actually going to save the elevator clip star for last. Oh, he does miss the long jump, and he's going in the hole.
That's a big fuck up.
Those animals go, it's,
Ooh. Oh, this is Jack's first MIPS miss of the night. Doing the slow and steady backup strat with the side flip. Just to make sure
he's already in DDD.
Of course, all of this time loss could be made up in DDD, seeing the way that Bob does this star.
Definitely the playthrough strats, the let's play strats, aren't the time-saving ones.
Yeah, and his swim speed isn't even bad. He does get a little bit of lag here, which makes it harder to time those swims, but he does a pretty good job. Oh, Bob, I think, has had enough of the bullying. He's going for the back fin. He's doing the big boy strategy.
There's no way he does it, dude.
We'll see if he can do it.
He's going to fuck it up.
And it was that easy the whole time.
Wow. I don't know why.
If he had done that in game two, he would have won. Obviously, being a little bit faster, but that's still, he's not getting the huge time loss of having catch cycle two. And again, Bob has a very good top of Bowser 2 with that left side long jump strategy. He has not messed up once all night. That might be the best strategy that Bob uses, the most advanced strategy in his run. Oh, and now we have Jack trying to show that he can do it too, but he's going to fall to level 2. Bob already heading to the first BLJ staircase as Jack winds up a good Bowser 2 throw. We'll see how quickly Bob can get these BLJs out. There's no pressure, but these BLJs are still nobody's friend.
Oh, he got it.
There it is.
Nuts.
The first try.
First try BLJ.
That's really what you want to see.
We now have Jack inserting his key to make his way to the first BLJ staircase. Bob is up, and he appears to be stuck in the pillar. You never want to end up in Spider Town with your second set of BLJs, but
or something. I don't know what happened there, but it will give Jack some extra time to play with.
Of course, that's only assuming Jack does get past his first set of BLJs. There it is. He is going through Bowser 3 with a pretty sizable lead on Jack, who is still working on his second set of BLJs. And there they are.
That is what really counts. So you have to measure it by throws. I would say two throws. And
yeah,
Bob misses,
this is
and
a two-throw
Jack
race.
Is ahead.
Jack extending that lead a little bit, though, as he falls into the pit below this first seesaw. So we will see Jack do his typical elevator ride into a triple jump strategy, as Bob is already entering the tube to start off his Bowser 3
throws. Unless he fucks throws really bad.
I mean, if you remember, I believe Jack had a 2042 last time, and he said he beat Bob's record. It's going to be close.
Perfect throws from Bob.
Bob did do some beautiful Bowser throws there. It's not going to PB for him, but it was darn close. Another pretty close race. I mean, Jack already doing his Bowser 3 throws.
Wow. It does make you think, what if this was a best of 5? What could have happened? Just looking at Bob's splits, he actually managed to get a few golds. And I think one of his golds was Dire Dire Duck, so there you have it.
I golded thrice. I golded 3 times that
round.
That was a good race.
Yeah, that was a good race.
I fucked it up in Bowser 2 because I was doing the strat that you're somehow fucking godly at, where you... I don't get it. I don't understand how, like, I practiced that for like an hour off stream and managed to get it like 3 times. I just don't
really
get it, dude. All right, I'm ready.
Both players ready?
Yep, I'm ready.
Will count us down for game 2 of match 2.
Alrighty, here we go. A potential decider on our hands. 3, 2, 1, and go. Neither players get it once again. They haven't been too hot with it, but... Okay, never mind. Both players.
Double Akitu. Now we'll see if they can both get Bomb Clip as well.
Bob just a handful of frames ahead at the moment. Both pretty much in sync.
They both make it to the gate.
That was almost the exact same gameplay on repeat. I wonder if we'll see a Bob first try count. I know he's got it in him. Ooh, Jack.
Jack going to the backup star first before Bob for maybe the first time. And Bob gets the first time cannonless. They may have swapped their game cams to trick the commentators because Bob is having the best womps he's had all night.
Once again, be dancing around with this penguin. I will make short work of it.
Oh! Jack is going downhill without the baby penguin. That's not gonna cut it. Ooh, Bob does miss the first throw on Bowser. We'll see if Jack can make some time up here if he gets this first throw right away.
Perfect throw.
There it is. That'll
good,
do it.
Looking good.
These Bowser's ooh, nearly in sync.
I think that's could be perfectly. No, Bob oh, just.
Jack missed the angle on that Bowser a little bit, which was enough to give Bob the lead back. That's how close this race is.
Oh.
This is the closest we've seen it all night.
Very close.
This is going to be a very exciting dungeon split. Star and Jack doesn't. I like seeing the two different movement strategies between the two players. An extra dive here, a bonus long jump there. There it is again. Another clean pyramid star from Jack. So we'll see Jack go for his first boulder star, as he likes to do. Bob going for his first emergency star. And Bob gets hit by the scuttlebug! He's going down to the depths!
Oh, there goes perfect. What little lead he had. This is good news for Jack. He will meet Toad, maybe with a little less angst and anger. And won't throw again!
Nope, another punch! Alright, he is fully healed up. No bonus health. Oh, one bonus health. So that would have been enough to survive a third bump if he had taken it. Let's see if Jack can confirm this on the first throw. There it is. Jack has.
I don't think I messed up a Bowser 2 throw tonight.
Bob makes his way up cycle one.
And Jack gets some adequate BLJs here to just secure somewhat of a lead. This has really been the turning point in a lot of these matches today.
He does finally get this Bowser 2 dead, and he can try to make his way over to Jack, who just got a good BLJ through the star door. This does largely depend on Jack at this point to get good BLJs on the second staircase, and also to have a no-death run through Bowser 3 if he wants to keep this lead.
Of course, of course. And as far as our trusty throws metric, how many throws do you reckon would have to be missed for Bob to make...
The timing is so difficult, it is basically luck-based.
Definitely.
Oh, ooh. Jack with the crazy long jump into the Goomba. The Goomba was there, so I thought he was going to just go with the side path, the little slightly longer path instead, but he went for it anyway and just slammed that Goomba. Bob is up the staircase. Jack has the first Bowser throw. I think Bob is going to have to hope that Jack dies at some point
one,
on this
two,
Bowser 3.
Two.
I have seen it happen. It's not impossible, but
we
oh, there's one
PB.
Throw missed. Bowser got that quick fire attack off, but it's not going to land on Jack. Oh, another miss.
That one not quite as close. Bob could actually earn some more time here. If
Bob's it's... climbing the tower. I still think Bob needs Jack to make a more major mistake, such as falling off this island, but...
Oh, my
that's the
God,
third
dude.
Missed throw on this second Bowser throw. Bowser in the sky,
uh-oh.
And that's
ooh,
it.
There it is. That's the third one from Jack. Three missed throws, three hit throws. It'll do.
Not a bad run, actually. The Bowser 3 at the end was a little shaky, but all in all, he still has a 21-minute run.
I was on PB pace. I was on it, and I lost it, dude.
That was the most spaghetti nervous Bowser 3 throws.
I fucked up. Once I died, I was like, ah, oh, there's no way I PB, man.
Yeah, very exciting. Very exciting to watch. And that will, of course, establish a Game 3 situation for this charity bracket.
That's frustrating. I'll get one more. Game
this
set.
Is it. Game 3. All right,
ready?
Here we go. In 3, 2, 1, go!
Yeah, please stay muted during the races, Bobs. Thanks. Just kidding.
Everyone appreciates it.
Trash talking. Wow.
Actually, Bob, for the sake of your chat, you might just want to mute your mic altogether. It's a bad way to start a run. It's also bad when you get stuck in a title screen loop because you keep resetting. But that's a missed bomb clip from Jack as Bob is through the gate. Okay, Bob didn't get the plank push. Which is a term that I learned tonight. And yeah, he's too close to that wall. He's going to have to set this canvas again as Jack is coming flying towards it. Ooh, he misses his ideal setup. Still trying to find it, though. Bob has canvas now. He's moving on. Jack is up on the plank push strategy. Let's see if he gets it nonetheless.
Yeah, we got it.
And both players have their cantless. Maybe Jack will pull off a first time throw here.
I do it like every time, but alright, sir. Alright, I'll listen to you.
I think both players will get this Bowser 1 throw, no problem. I think it's going to be Bowser 3 where we see the most difficulty, but Bob is falling off the stage. Jack is missing the tail. Jack is getting pushed around by the first Bowser. Finally gets it into the bomb, but Bob has a huge time loss. Oh, and he's ground pounding for good luck at the top of the carousel.
It's obviously not looking good for Bob, but things are very, it's very changeable from here on out.
Oh,
unless he keeps
finds that electrode. Hopefully
Bob
he gets it together and brings this
Bob peaked in high school.
Well, let's once again see one of the most satisfying stars in this whole game, the pyramid.
Oh, okay.
Triple jump dive.
I had to hold my breath there while Bob killed that Bowser because I just had to see him get out of the stage. And yes, there it is again. Jack pulling off a beautiful pyramid star.
Saved a little bit of time.
Massively executed. Very well done.
I wouldn't be surprised if he makes cycle one with even the very beginning of it.
Ooh, green demon challenge coming very close there.
Fuck, I do that every time.
Walk on the bully platform and he's getting bullied!
This cycle, it'll do. It will.
Ground pound for good luck, and he's going the wrong way. Oh, he barely catches that ledge. And there it is from Jack. Bowser 2 is dead on the flat of his back for the last time tonight. If he lands this correctly, which so far so good, that's a pretty good time save. Yeah, oh, he hit. No, he hit the lava too early. Oh. He's not going to make it. That is a gigantic death on Bowser 2 from Bob. We would really need to see a Jack entering wet dry world kind of situation here.
Yes, absolutely.
Oh, well, good BLJs at the second staircase. That's a miss, Bowser 2 throw from Bob.
Ooh,
man.
Could be one of the nails in the coffin. Not all of them, but...
I think that was the last shovel full of dirt over the coffin, quite frankly. I think Jack is still on PB pace. He did take a slow and careful Bowser 3 there. He may have lost a little bit of time. But if he lands all three of these throws, I think he might have a new PB on the final race of the night. The first throw is good.
That would be quite a way to end it off, but obviously I don't want to put too much pressure, so...
Oh, that's the missed second throw. I don't know if it's still going to be possible. I'm not sure how early of a 20-minute PB he has, but I have to assume that missed throw is going to cost it. Well, the second throw comes out cleanly, and now there's just one throw left between Jack and this final star, as Bob does make it into Bowser in the Sky.
No.
I know that one hurts, that last missed throw.
Damn.
With that missed throw, definitely the chance of PB is out the window. But this is still, I think, missed.
It fell short. That
did it fall short or
right there,
fall over
lines.
The mine?
Over? Wow, okay.
Because I think he had a good enough angle. It was like only slightly off center where if it was a little bit of a shorter throw, I think it would have worked. Just really
just
unfortunate.
Dude,
oh.
Another miss! This could be an unbelievable catch up from Bob. Anything.
Bob is falling further in Bowser 3 than Bowser is on Jack's screen. But Jack has missed another Bowser 3 throw.
What the fuck is going on, man? Fuck, I don't have my actual window pulled up. Oh, shit.
Jack is spaghettiing so hard.
Fuck.
Another missed throw.
Dude,
this Bowser.
10 missed throws. That could be number 5.
We're actually going to PB, actually. Jesus Christ.
That'll do it.
I'm not taking a breath until I see him actually grab this star at this rate. Before all I know, he's going to miss
Jack,
it.
Jack, jump off. Jack, jump up for the charity. Jack, jump for charity. For charity. Jump off.
Bob with a very desperate final attempt asking Jack to jump off. Apparently for charity.
Ooh, some ground pounds coming out. Bob,
Jack, just jump off. Just go, just dive off, I'm telling you, dude, for charity.
Toying with his food here.
Straight for the Alzheimer's charity.
For shit, for children. Not obviously, no, you don't understand, Jack. You just have to just jump off.
What is Jack gonna do? He has the final win in his hand. Oh, he teases the runoff with a side flip.
Oh, my hero. Past the Goomba.
Oh, and that's it. Jack has the final star.
I had to do it. I had to do it.
I've never seen that level of disrespect coming out at the end of a Mario throw. Especially after that many missed throws.
Dude, oh my god. If we hit all throws, we would have PB'd, actually.
Yeah, yeah.
I would have had at least a 10-second PB.
Dude, Bowser throws.
Dude, I'm usually not that bad.
The pressure of a PB is so hard.
Dude, I know. I count, and I didn't want to count out loud because my mic was unmuted for you guys. So I was like, and then also I was playing through, like, my OBS window. And I was like, this is bad.
Wow, I can't believe Jack dislikes charity. Wow,
I dislike charity.
Alzheimer's.
I'll donate with you. I don't care. It was all fun. It was all for fun.
Good wow. games, boys.
That was fun.
Very good games.
That was fun, man.
I'll tell you. Okay. Man, what a journey. What a journey.
What a journey.
That was a great race, man. That was so much fun. Definitely. Journey, we gotta. So soon enough, we'll have a picture of. So, Bob, what I want you to do is, once you get the dyed hair, I'm going to have you send it to me, a picture. And I'm going to get a frame, and I'm going to hang it up on my wall and say, my first race won.
But why does everybody always do